Hi, welcome to a very special Sarah's Painting Bonanza. It's a very special one today because it's a very personal one. I'm doing a painting of my grandpa.
Sarah's Painting Bonanza.
Yeah. He passed away this past December, and we're having a memorial for him coming up, and this painting is going to be presented at the memorial. I'm really honored and excited to be doing this painting. It certainly conjured up a lot of memories. I've got so many great memories of him, and so many stories that are just so him. He had such an interesting personality. You know, he loved boxing and Rush Limbaugh. I found him so funny, and he could always make me laugh. One time a couple of years ago when I was visiting him with Grandma, we were having lunch, so I went to the cafeteria and got some coffee for him, and a fresh pot, it had just been brewed, and gave him a cup of coffee, and you know, he picks it up, he's like 97, 98, and he picks up this mug, you know, very carefully, brings it to his lips, and takes a sip. It's hot. I'm like, oh my god, I burned my 98-year-old grandpa. I'm like, in a panic. I'm like, oh, is it too hot? Is it too hot, grandpa? He just goes, it's good. And for you, those of you that know him, that's hilarious because he really liked a hot cup of coffee. Actually, my grandpa was pretty active in his retirement. He was a prolific reader, tennis. He very fit, very active, and writer as well. He wrote short stories. Inventor. He invented a machine to test the hardness of steel. And one time he asked me to type up a story that he had written. I started typing it, and I realized it wasn't a story at all. Actually, it was a letter to an author of a book that he had read. The book was about the formation of the Earth, how life began on Earth. And his letter was something like, you know, I really enjoyed your book. However, I have to disagree with you on one point. You left out the influence of God in Earth's creation. And you have to understand, my grandpa wasn't an overtly religious person. He was very scientific-minded, very logical, very intelligent person. And usually when you hear, you know, religious arguments, they reference the Bible, they reference religious texts, but his argument actually was very grounded in science and grounded in logic, and it was pretty convincing, actually. I'm typing and going, this is some good points he's making. Other thing that he was very well known for in my family were his incredibly long, arduous walks. He would go on these crazy walks. He would take off for hours and hours. We wouldn't know where he was. We get kind of worried. He'd go on these long walks, and the thing is, you never knew when one was coming. He says, oh, Sarah, you want to come to the library with me? And I say, yeah, sure, Grandpa, let's go to the library. The library is two towns over. Of course, I don't know this. He didn't say anything about this. We just start walking. I think we're walking to the library, you know, a couple of blocks away. And, you know, an hour's passing, 2 hours. And I'm like, where is this library? Is there even a library? Eventually, we do get to the library. And he returns his book that he brought and picks up the book that he already planned and intended to pick up. So we're in the library maybe a total of 5 minutes after this 2 hour walk. And then we turn around and start walking back. We get back to the condo. Here he is, this, you know, 80 some year old man. No problem at all, sits down, has a coffee, opens his book, checks out the new book he got, settles in, and here I am, this young, sprightly 12-year-old, completely passed out on the couch, dead to the world, like, I'm so wiped out from this walk, I can't even move. So he could outwalk anyone. Outwalk anyone, anywhere, anytime. So, I am working from a black and white photo. It's right here, and it's coming along really well so far, although what I'm finding particularly challenging is his expression of the photo, which is what I really love about it. It's smiling, but he's kind of got this little glint in his eye, like a little bit sarcastic, like he's smiling because he's thinking of something, you know, very clever, some clever turn of phrase that he's about to say that you'll have to think about for a second and be like, oh yeah, that is pretty funny. I did a time-lapse capture of the painting, and I set it to music that he likes, so I really hope you enjoy it. Sad. I really miss him. He's a really awesome person. Really great to talk to. And I hope this painting does him a little bit of justice. Thanks so much for stopping by, hearing some stories about my grandpa. Hope you enjoyed the painting, and I'll see you next time.